Have you seen my Museum of Egyptian Antiquities, Crystal?
I don't think I have.
I built that a while ago, and I based it on the museum in Cairo, the original museum in Cairo.
Should we go there next?
Sure, if you like.
Sure.
Oh, I guess I could have just said it instead of typing it. Fair sparkle.
You're as bad as me.
Forgot people can't hear me. So yeah, outside the museum, they have this little water area, so I tried to copy that, seeing pictures of it.
What an interesting design on the steps. Are those lampposts?
No, these are the yellow stuff. That is the God, what's it called? What's it called? Somebody say it, say it. God. It's the incense burners.
I never
And the
remember the
party
name of
supply.
anything. I know what things look like, but when it comes to names, it's just like,
Yeah.
no.
It's a balmy incense burner. That's what it is. It's under party supply and decorations.
We need more yellow.
True that. Yeah, we don't really have a lot of yellow stuff. And I
The
tried to copy
outside's
the
beautiful.
entrance, like in the picture, and then inside, of course, it's more like my imagination, so. There's a pharaoh, there's all these different vessels where his organs are in. I forgot what you call it, but there are some mummies.
I'd probably just call it guts in a jar.
I like that. Guts in a jar.
Bit of gore.
And then I saw on a website, like a real exhibition of a mummified monkey and mummified dog. So I'm like, oh my God, I have to recreate that. So I did a mummified monkey and a mummified dog. Well, the dog, came ready-made, but the monkey I made upstairs. If you
I'm
guys want to
covering my
see
dog's ears.
it. It's up the stairs here.
Yeah, I apologize. I always get lost. Sorry.
How can you get lost? It's not that big here.
I can get
Know which
lost
I want to look at
anywhere, I
first.
promise you.
That is really cool.
Had fun doing that.
Kind of looks like the dog's gonna eat him.
I know, right? But no worries, they're both mummified.
Yeah, they're already dead, it's fine.
It's just different scrolls exhibited here and ancient texts. And then of course we have a public bathroom. 'Cause what dimension is incomplete complete without a bathroom? Hello.
Well, yeah, people need to go to the toilet.
Yeah. Especially when they come with little kids and stuff, hello. I even have a diaper changing table here.
How thoughtful.
I know, right? That's me.
I'm pretty sure this is the first dimension I've seen with baby changing facilities.
Heck, it's a public space!
Yeah, if you didn't put it in a public space, there'd be an outcry.
I know, right? I don't want to hear these complaints from all these mothers. Then above the toilet, we have the hieroglyphics for male and female. Well, at least in my world.
No, that's a really nice touch. Really nice touch.
And you can take the boat back to the mainland. All aboard!
Now, have you entered this one in any contest or anything?
Yeah, Fiendish had a long time ago had a and I believe it was Fiendish. She had a contest for public places. People had to build like a public place, and that's why I built it. So a lot of my inspiration comes from other people, like trying to get me to build something. You know, like doing a contest. I'm like, what could I do?
Contests definitely make you think a lot.
Yep. Challenge you. I like that. You know.
Yeah, I like a challenge, but I'm a bit of a stress head, so I tend to get a little bit stressed out with them. But it's still I still find it enjoyable.
Yeah. Well, that is true. At least it's an enjoyable contest, not like an exam at school. Ugh, no, they stressed me out.
Oh yeah, I missed half of mine.
Well, that's pretty much all it on here.